Welcome back. I hope you all had a really good week. So this week we are doing what are their intentions towards you. We haven't done an intentions one for so long that I figured it was time, or we as in me and guides figured it was time to redo an intentions one. So deck number one, deck number two, think about you, think about your person, and we will get into the strongest mutual energy between you all. As always, works on strongest mutual energy. Number one, number two, go where your heart is pulling you. There's my dog, her little head popping around the corner. Number one, number two, what are their intentions? Okay, so yeah, as always, it'll work on the strongest mutual energy between you all, regardless of situations, regardless of what is going on in your situations. Go into all your energies, go into all your people's energies, and pull out the strongest mutual energy between you all. Think about your person. Can we get into their person's thoughts, feelings, energy, emotions, and thought processes? And let's do all possibilities, probabilities, choices, chances, and changes of your person as well. And can you please tell us what are their intentions? I've got Daydream Believer by the Beatles. Was it the Beatles that did that? Just really quickly. Daydream Believer and the Homecoming. Cannot sing. Clairaudience, hearing spirit, radios in my ears where I get dials and hear songs, but I cannot sing. Okay, can you tell me please, what are their people's intentions? Anyone knows me, knows that I sing like a drowned rat. What are their people's intentions? Okay, so your person is likely to have retreated from this situation at this moment in time. All right, you might feel that nothing's happened, as if they've backed away. They could be blowing hot and cold with you. Anything along those lines could be happening as your collective energy. They have a lot of fear going on in their mind. They have a lot of fear going on in their heart. So a few of them have kind of stepped away from the situation. So with regard to their intentions with you at the moment, they really are just thinking through what it is they want, what they want from the situation, and what they want from themselves and their own life. They can see that they've kind of left you behind a little bit. And again, the reason for that is because they've got these fears. Now, the fears with regard to them is to do with heartbreak. It's to do with everything kind of falling down around them. They're also a little bit worried about what people might think and what people might feel about you and them. And they take on other people's judgments. They take on other people's opinions, and they kind of have left you. You're feeling a little bit left at the waistline at this moment in time. Now, they might not have expressed this to you. So if they haven't, at least now you kind of know what's going on. They've walked away from the situation at the moment because the fears and the energy has got a bit too much for them, taking on people's emotions, taking on people's stance on it. Let me just move my laptop before my dog chucks it on the floor. Okay, so they're having a period of rest from the situation at the moment. They're taking it all in their stride, really. They are still thinking of you. They are still feeling things about you. They are still picking up on you. They are still having sexual dreams, more dreams about you. So they can't really get a shot of you as what they thought they wanted to. So they've walked away from the situation at the moment, but there is movement back towards you equally. Now when they have, so period of rest, thinking it through, detaching themselves from the situation, been feeling quite pressured about it, mainly because of other people putting an influence on it, and then this movement back towards you. I'm also hearing that with some of your people, they might be involved with someone else. Again, you will know about that if that is the case. And with this energy kind of pointing downwards, this is for the females. When I worked in a prison, oh, this is going to sound really morbid. I worked in a prison, and it was a really, really old prison. And when they used to hang people there, there's on the walls, there's the arrows down for where they hung the women, and the arrows up for where they hung the men. So that's a bit morbid. I'm not talking about hanging people, but this arrow down is talking about that they are still thinking about you, making these moves towards you. Again, it's also a representation of sexual energy between the two of you. So intentions wise, at the moment, they haven't really got any. They're just going with the flow of it. there is the sexual thoughts, sexual feelings. Maybe you could have a bit of lust with them. But as far as commitment and things like that go, at this moment in time, your person is kind of stepping away from that situation. Now, to revert this back, when this movement comes back towards you, which it will, keeping your power, keeping your Queen of Swords energy and your High Priestess energy, rather than the Queen of Cups, rather than going emotional, stand in your bitch power, say, look, this is on my terms. And if it's just going to be sexual, if you're okay with that, be okay with that. But if you want something more, say, you know, take me out, wine and dine me. Let's see where this goes. Stay in the moment with them, because if you start planning a future and thinking everything's going to be beautiful, roasting, you know, going in the right way, you're gonna freak them out. Okay, so really stay in the moment with them. But if you don't, if you want something more than sexual, call the shots on it. You are the one calling the shots, not them. So yeah, they might have stepped away, but when they come back with some kind of offer towards you, make sure you are the one calling the shots on whether that is what you want. Staying in your power, again, sexual energy coming forward, but you also have your victory card over here with your masculine energy in the background. So intentions wise at the moment, there isn't particularly any. They're having a bit of a break from it all. Then there's going to be some sexual intentions coming towards you, but if you handle it right, you call the shots, put it on your terms and say, well, you know, I want more than sex. And if they say no, then, you know, that's it. You can focus on someone else if that's what you want, or you can go and have a bit of fun with them, whatever you want to do. But their intentions here, if you stand in your power and tell them what you want, majority of you, it's going to turn in your favor, and your person is going to be there with their heart energy on their sleeve. This little person's got a heart on their chest, sitting on their wands, which is their victory. So you will be on top of your game with it all. So at the moment, it's probably not the intentions that you want. Probably you're probably feeling a little bit sad, a little bit low from it all, but it's going to shift back in your favor, in your direction, if you step in your power, and then you can get these intentions going whichever direction you would like them to. Okay, that's deck number one. Let's do deck number two. Hello, my beauties. If you've just tapped in, tuned in, turned on, and welcome to the channel if you're new. This works on the strongest mutual energy between you all. That's how I read. Go into all your energies, go into all your people's energy, and pull out the strongest mutual energy of you all, regardless of situations and circumstances. So, just going into your guys' energy, think about your people. So if anything doesn't resonate, remember it for a later date, or it's possible that you aren't part of the strongest mutual energy that everyone else is, and you might need to book a private reading. If you want to book a private reading anyway, just give me a holler. But I did say think about your person, but if I didn't say it again, think about your person, let's get into their thoughts, feelings, energy, emotions and thought processes of their people. And let's do all possibilities, probabilities, choices, chances and changes of their people as well. This deck is ready to go, it's bursting. It's like, come on Ali, hurry up. But I want to make sure that energies, the reason why the shuffling is important is because why it's important to watch the shuffling, which I know is boring, but it gets your energy directly into the cards, and if you just skip forward to the outcome, your energy doesn't go enough. Okay, can you tell me what deck number two is? What are their intentions towards the people watching? What are their intentions? Do you want seven again? I've got Daylight by Taylor Swift coming through my right ear. Now I see daylight. You've really made them analyse who they are as a person, you know. You've really made them analyse what they want, who they are. There's really not anywhere for them to hide anymore. They've hidden that song, they've hidden in this 20-year-long day, dark night, and now they see daylight. You've given them that wake-up call that they need. But equally, when that happens, your person's had a freak, might have the potential to get their knickers in a twist and have a bit of a freak out. So, with regard to you and your person and their intentions towards you, they know that they have got to make a choice and a decision, because they can't keep you dangling with a carrot. They can't keep that going, it's not working. They know that if they don't make a choice on it, they are gonna lose you. They know that they're is stuff that they have got to get, that they've got to get sorted first. So at the moment, your person is kind of pressing pause on it while they're sorting their own stuff out. Now, this is especially if they are involved with someone else and maybe they're married or living with kids. They do want to be with you, but they have got a lot of stuff that needs to get sorted first. So they know that there's this choice and decision to be made. They're very frightened of making these choices and these decisions. They're worried that if they are with someone else, this isn't all of you, but if they are with someone else and they're married and they've got kids, they want to be with you, but they're a little bit worried that it's not going to work out between the two of you, and then they're going to end up resenting you. Okay, because if it doesn't work out between the two of you and they've lost their, well, they feel that they've lost that connection in that home life, they're going to panic over it. Okay, so their intentions are that they want to be with you, but they have these overwhelming fears and anxieties. It's a bit of a dark card, really. Yeah, it's quite cool, but it feels like they feel like they're kind of just driving into this black tunnel at the moment, don't know where the end is, don't know what's going to happen, and these fears are kind of overwhelming them because they know that they have to make a choice, they know that they have to make a decision, but they just don't really know how at the moment. So they're hiding. If you're trying to communicate with them whilst they are in hidden mode, you are not going to get a response. Wait for them to come out of this cave, man cave, woman cave, whatever equivalent, and they will make moves towards you. Okay, at the moment, if they backtrack from it, leave them be, don't chase them, don't call them, egg does not chase sperm, even though we're not sexually orientated or gender specific, you get what I'm trying to say. Don't go chasing them because you will back them into a corner and that will push them away, especially when they know they have a choice to make on it. They're hiding away from things at the moment. Now, with the orange on this that's kind of stuck over their head, they're trying to pretend that there isn't a problem equally. So they know they've got to make a choice on it, but they're not willing to do anything about that just yet. So they're going to just stick an orange over your head and be like, okay, she's just a bit of fruit, or they're just a bit of fruit, which is just growing, and I'm going to pretend that the whole thing isn't really happening, because I know that this means when I acknowledge it, it means I have to make a choice on it. Okay, so they're hiding, they are hiding from things. Now, equally, at the same time, they don't want to hurt you. They know that they've hurt you in the past. They don't want to hurt you again. And they know that part of the reason why they've hurt you in the past is because they haven't communicated properly with you. So they know through these choices and decisions that communication is going to have to be key for the two of you to kind of come together. They do want to be with you, but circumstances are kind of dictating otherwise at the moment. It does feel to be more circumstantial that you two aren't together. If it wasn't for circumstances, and the two of you were just you and them, you would be perfect and it's a match made in heaven, but circumstances are what is dictating these, your people's intentions within deck number two. Could be family, could be friends, it also could be lovers or wives or husbands or girlfriends, boyfriends, etc, etc, and they haven't communicated it properly to you. They are still thinking about you if you're not in contact. You are at the back of their mind with the moon being in the back energy, but they just don't know how to progress with it. They're scared of making these moves forward, and then it's like they're going to poison themselves as such. You know, they'll make this choice and they're worried that it is the wrong choice at this moment in time. So time is going to be the biggest way for this to move in your favor. Again, they are hiding from things at the moment, pretending that there isn't issues between the two of you, that you know, that everything's just going to work out, but they have these massive underlying fears. They're not where they want to be at this moment. They aren't where they want to be. They're pretty fed up with their own life. They're feeling that they're kind of existing rather than living at the moment. They also feel that their soul is kind of pulling them in a different direction. So at the moment, they're trying to battle their logical mind and their soul. Their soul will always win, but they are going to put up a good fight for that, because again, they're scared of making changes, which is going to be detrimental to them. And that's their fears. They're worried about these fears, that everything's going to go wrong, people are going to hate them, or that it's not going to work out and they've given up their life to be with you. They're not really focusing on the here and now, going with the flow. They know that you want a future, they know that you want the whole package, the families, the babies, the house, the mortgage, the kids, or whatever equivalent. They know that you want all of that. They're very, very clear on that. You don't need to keep reiterating it to them that you want a future. They see you as quite soft, not soft in a bad way, but they see you as a very gentle energy, and they don't want to hurt you again. So this could potentially be why they've also retreated. So with intentions here, they want to be with you, but the block is they don't know how. They don't know how at the moment. Time is going to be the way for this one to move forward. Their emotions are very, very strong. There's also a very sad feeling here. They almost feel like Romeo and Juliet is the wrong kind of story, because you guys could have a better story than that. But these overwhelming fears on making these choices. Now, if they don't make the choices, the universe will do it for them. The universe will do it for them. They know that they want to be with you. They just don't really know how. So they're pretending that there isn't a problem, which isn't going to... They're pretending there isn't a problem. They're pretending that nothing's really happening. They're in this complete avoidance. Nothing's really going on. But from there, they will come back towards you. Will it have moved forward? It depends on your individual circumstances, on what your people decide to do about it. But they know that they have to do something or they're going to lose you for good. But they're very, very frightened of doing it. So intentions-wise at the moment... going with the flow, they're just going with the flow of it, knowing that they've got to do something but really scared of doing it, so they're just going to take it each day at a time at the moment, take it all in their stride and see where you guys end up. And that is deck number two. Okay, so if you want me, just drop me a message, drop me an email. I've also got Facebook and Instagram opened up, so you can message me on there. I'm quicker to reply to on email, so if you do need me, email is best. Website's up and running, and if you need any further details, just give me a shout. So have a wonderful week, guys. Look after yourselves and take care. Lots of love. Bye.